Hello, boys and girls. Today we're going to do a science experiment called sink or float. You get to see what things sink and what things float and why. So here are some materials we need. I'm going to show you now. You're going to need a tub of water. Now, I'm using this tub of water. You can use any container of water. If you don't have it, you can use a kitchen sink, fill that up with water, or maybe your bathtub, fill it up with water. Or any deep container that you can fill in where it's deep enough where you can see the things sink or float. Now, since this is a science experiment, I really want to challenge you to predict and think first before doing the activity. After you gather some tools, I have here a toy tomato. I have a medicine bottle that is empty, plastic bottle, a popsicle stick, a button, a toy cube, a kitchen spoon, a toy doll, and a coin. Now first, what I want you to do is make a chart. You can make it however you want. Ms. Munoz made it like this. I put a line in the middle. I put up here sink with a little picture of the object sinking, and I put up here float with the object floating in the water. This is going to be where you predict and make your observations. So you can put it on the floor and you can put what you think is going to sink or float. Like, I think this is going to float. I think this kitchen spoon is going to sink. So you can put it in like this. I'll show you up so you can see it a little better. Just like this. And you can put the items like this in each section where you think it's going to belong. Then after you put all of them, you can go ahead and test it with the water. Now, if I put this, do you think it's going to sink or float? Let's see. It floats. Now, if I put the kitchen spoon, let's see what happens. Oh, it went straight to the bottom. It sunk. If I put a plastic container, it is going to float as well. So let's go ahead and I'll take them out. I'll dry them a little bit with a towel so it doesn't get the paper wet. And I'll put them where they belong on the chart so you can see after. This one also floats. So I'll put it here. The kitchen sink, the kitchen spoon sinked, sunk. So we put it here. What about the popsicle stick? Let's see. Do you think it'll sink or float? Make a decision. Let's try it. It floats. So we'll go ahead and put it in the float section. Let's try one more. A coin. Oh, it went down. It sunk to the bottom. So this one sinks. Now, why do things sink and why do things float? This is a big word called density. Density is that everything is made up of small little molecules, so small you can't even see them. But even we have molecules. But in these molecules, if they are very, very tight together, like if they're hugging, kind of like this block, if they're really, really hugging, then it makes it more dense. It is high density, so it will sink to the bottom. Now, if it's something like a button that has less density, or something that is hollow, where it's around but there's nothing inside, when you put it in, they will float because they are less dense, making them float in water. It is a big word, density. We should practice that one. Now you can try this with many, many tools or many toys. Like I was saying, kitchen tools. Maybe you can find your bathtub toys. Those are hollow, so maybe you can try that to see. And I also got a straw, because when you put some things to float, maybe you can try a little experiment. When you blow on them, they move around. How fun is that? Now, if you want to make this a little more fun or creative, you can put some food coloring drops into the water to make it a colored water for the boys and girls. Or you can also put jello powder, because jello powder won't sink into jello, but it'll give it color to the water, and it'll actually smell really, really well. So it encourages more senses as they are doing this activity. Now, I have also attached a video so you can learn a little more about what sink and float is all about. Thank you. I hope you enjoy.